Hello everyone. Today we will talk about what is a SWIFT code and why it plays a vital role in international trade and finance, and as a matter of fact, any kind of international financial transaction. The full form of SWIFT is Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication. So, what do you understand from the name? It is a cooperative society headquartered in Belgium, not the kind of cooperative societies that we know of in India. It is a society where the members are banks and financial institutions, and it is a method of telecommunication between banks throughout the world for sending financial messages. Now, why do banks use this? They use this because SWIFT provides a way to encrypt the financial messages between the banks in such a way that only the sender bank and the receiver bank will know the details. No one in between can break the encryption. Now, you can imagine the value of international financial transactions performed every day. It is in millions of US dollars. So, a strong and robust encryption system is vital. Also, messages sent through SWIFT are almost real time, meaning you send a SWIFT message from India to suppose New York, it will reach in minutes. So, for any kind of financial message that has to be sent from one bank to another, for example, sending a letter of credit, a bank guarantee, a payment from an importer to an exporter, all are done through SWIFT. Now, what is a SWIFT code? It is basically a unique ID for a bank which is a part of the SWIFT system. It is also known as BIC code or the bank identifier code. Now, let's see the structure of a SWIFT code. The first four characters stand for the name of the bank. The next two stand for the country in which the bank branch is located. The next two is for the location, and the last three are optional for that particular branch. So SBIN stands for State Bank of India. IN is for the country India. BB is the location of the headquarters of SBI, that is the erstwhile Bombay. And 103 is the code for that particular branch. This is for overseas branch Bombay. It can either be numbers or letters like this one, which is the Foreign Exchange Department of SBI. This one is SBI, but in USA. And where in USA? 33 is the location code for New York. The next one is Bank of Baroda in New York. As you can see, the branch code is optional as these banks have only one branch in New York. So suppose Bank of Baroda, New York, will send a SWIFT message to SBI Overseas Branch, Mumbai. It will put SBIN INBB 103 in the receiver field of the SWIFT message, and it will reach the branch in encrypted format within minutes. I will talk about various SWIFT message types used in international trade in my next tutorial. Now, please remember, all branches of a bank does not have a SWIFT code. Only branches dealing with foreign exchange transaction will have a SWIFT code. So if you have an account at a branch which does not have a SWIFT code and you want to receive international fund, or suppose you want to receive a letter of credit, then what to do? Simply ask your branch which branch receives SWIFT messages on its behalf. Usually it is the nearest branch with a SWIFT code. If you like this video, please subscribe to us. You can also check out this beautiful playlist on trade finance with a variety of concepts explained simply.